Have you ever had trouble sizing a ring without rebuilding the whole model? Today, I'm going to show you three different ways to size different ring models, especially for the one with the stone on it. I will also show you my 3D model tricks and tips on saving information in the background. Let's get started. The first ring we are going to size is this very simple ring band. This is very easy way to make it by going to the sweep one. You have rail cross section, and I always like to move the seam to the inside of a ring band, and that's how I get with this. If you are going to size it smaller, let's say we're gonna give it a new rail over there, and you are going to size it down like this way. Have it close to there. It is okay for this type of a ring band if it is really thick, but keep in mind that you also size the thickness and also the width of this ring band. If you want to keep it the same thickness, a lot of time only things you need to do is move this cross section down to the new rail. So when you making a new ring like this, sweep one, using the new rail and the same cross section, then you can get it a smaller size by keeping all the way the same thickness. The second ring we are going to size is this band with a stone all the way around. For the first ring, you could just size 3D size it down, it's okay, but if you're doing the 3D size on this one, all the stone is not going to fit. Right, so we cannot just 3D size this one. We definitely need to do some editing on the profile. All we need to do now is moving entire profile and the stone. Let's move it from the outside rail to the new rail, which is the size we're going to have. And all we need to do is we're gonna do the sweep rail and cross section to get the ring band, which is in the right size, and then we will go ahead to do the polar array on this stone. The reason we need to redo the polar array is because the gap between the stone might be slightly different. So this one, since you have a stone go all the way, you definitely need to rebuild it. But keep in mind that my little trick is I never did it this curve. After I build a model, I'll put it into the separate layer, because if I have the curve, I can easily to rebuild anything very quick. The third ring we are going to talk about is sometimes you have the center stone and with complicated design on the side, so you definitely doesn't want to change anything over there. So we have a way to build it is by cage edit. So what we're gonna do is we are going to pick up the whole things without a stone, and then let's type it cage edit. With cage edit, we want to choose the first option for bounding box, and then we want to take a look. You might need to try a couple times to get the best count on it. I'm just gonna take a look on the default and see what's coming up for 4, X, Y, and Z. All right, so let's go ahead to take a look on the front view. At the front view, I have this smaller diameter of the red color curve for the ring shank it's going to be. So instead of choosing the whole things, I'm gonna choose whatever on the bottom. And I'm going to use the gumbo to scale it down like this. You won't get 100% correct, but you will get something really close. So as you can see, you might do a little bit calculation. It's coming in very tightly. Even I get it way too much. But on the top is like a little bit room. So it's kind of compensate a little bit. It won't be super accurate, but that way you won't change anything on the top. You still maintain the stone size and all the detail on the top. And all we do is shrinking the bottom a little bit. You will change the thickness a little bit in this case. And this is good for when you size about a half size up and half size down. If you size it way too much, and that will deform it a lot. And again, once you like it, you can hit the ES escape key, and then you can delete this box. You can see I keep all my curve in there. Just want to make sure that I can rebuild the whole thing. So please keep your curve in. You can keep it in a separate layer so you can change it much easier. On top of what I offer now in my channel, I would like to expand my channel content to all 3D model printing subjects. I'm curious about what you like to know the most. For example, you can ask me how to be a freelance jewelry designer, the advice for the Rhino beginner, should I buy Rhino Gold or Metric Gold? Can Rhino do an organic shape? Should I go to the college for jewelry design, etc. The more detail on the questions, the more accurate feedback I can give back. Please leave your question in the comments below. Let me know what you'd like to know about Rhino or the related subjects. I will collect all the information and may be able to do additional videos to answer all your curiosity. Thank you and see you next Monday.